Welcome back to the video, Servlet Request Handling. In this video, we are going to study Servlet Request Handling. I am Professor Dattatray Gandhmal from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So, in the previous video, we have seen how to write a servlet program in Eclipse. Now, let us see servlet request. What will be the learning outcome in this video? At the end of the session, students will be able to write a simple HTML page to pass data to Servlet. Now, Servlet is not only mean to write a program directly. We don't intend to write Servlet program directly. Instead, user writes a HTML page and passes the data from HTML page to Servlet so that Servlet request will do the thing. It will take the data, process it, and send back the result. So this is how Servlet is usually called, not directly. So HTML play an important role over here. HTML pass the data to Servlet. So let us see about all these things in detail. Don't worry. Servlet request interface. Why Servlet request interface is required? We have to initialize and we have to declare that what type of Servlet program you are going to write. So here basically I am going to use the methods inside response and request like content type, content length, parameter name and attributes, etc. So these are all the things client information is required. To avail the client information, so what kind of page it is, how much the length is. So these all things can be identified and can be gathered this information through this particular information like content type, content length, parameter names and attributes. We'll come to this later. Now, what are the different methods inside servlet request interface? These are some important methods which are present inside servlet request interface. So when I want to pass the data from HTML page to this thing, servlet, then I pass the data using these methods. And those data is collected at servlet end using these methods. Servlet get parameter values, get content length. So these methods help us what type of data has been sent from HTML. So when an HTML page is sending a data, that data is received using these methods. So basically it has a signature string return type, get parameter is a method name and a string name is an input parameter. So this is how method is read. This is a signature of get parameter. Public, it is public. These all methods are public. String is a return type, get parameter is a method name, and input parameter is a string name. So it is going to accept string name. So this is how get parameter helps us to collect data that is passed from HTML. HTML also needs to pass the data in a specific format. So we will see to it. Now let us take a demonstration directly without wasting a time. I'll come down to Eclipse. This is what Eclipse previously we were doing in the last video. Demo servlet we have done in the previous video, right? So here continuing, what has to be done? If I maximize this, you can see here we had written this doGet method. Inside doGet method, we had written response.getContentType, response.get this thing, print writer we have used to display welcome to the first servlet, right? So continuing with that, I have deleted that particular code. I'll write a fresh code over here. We will see to it. Then if I come back over here, what has to be done? If you remember the root structure, what is the root structure at the web directory of servlet? If I want to write any HTML pages, HTML pages will reside directly inside root folder. Now what is root folder here? Web content is a root folder over here. So if I want to write any HTML pages, I will right click over here, new. I'll take an HTML page. Okay, I'll make it here. index.html index.html page. Okay, now I'll finish it. Now one index.html file will be created. I'll delete this because this is a by default code which comes as a default page of HTML. Instead of this, let us write some code. This code is required. You can just note it down. So I'll paste this code over here. What is this code? Form action. Action is welcome over here. Method is get. Enter your name. So it is just a form. I'm creating a form over here to enter the name. So when a user enters a name, that name has to be passed to Servlet. So Servlet has to receive this name. Okay, so input type is text, text is a type, and name is, this is a key for that name. So what name we are passing, this name should be unique. Then input type is submit, so submit button will come. So this is a general form in HTML, I don't go into detail of it. So once you write this HTML code, okay, now we need to go back to demo Servlet. When a user clicks on submit, this data has to be passed to demo Servlet. Okay, so what demo Servlet has to do, demo Servlet has to accept this particular form, the data from that form, right? For that, I have a code over here. Let us take this code and I'll paste it over here. So here it is the same thing which we have done in the last video, response dot set content type. Here set content type is HTML print writer. Here it, again it should be response dot print get writer. It is used for writing a purpose. And your important thing is request.get parameter. What request.get parameter is going to do? It is accepting name. If you remember, here we are passing name. This keyword is matched over here. Get parameter is going to take that name and return its value. That value, whatever you're going to type in the text, will be passed inside this particular string name. Okay, then what I'm doing, just to make sure that, okay, I've received the correct data, I'm printing. pw.printwrite, this println, welcome, that particular name. Okay, it makes sense, I think. After that, you have to close it. Let's close the connection. Okay, now this is what we have done in index.html file. So how to execute it? We have already seen how to execute this particular file. So index.html is residing inside web content. So now come down to test 151, right click, run as, run on server, save the changes, finish. It should execute now. The Servlet has started. Okay, this is the form which we have created. Enter your name. I'll enter my name as Ankit. So enter your name, Ankit. Login. It will show an error. It is showing an error because here, it is going, if you see here detail, it is going to welcome page, but we don't have any welcome Servlet over here. So what changes has to be done? Come down to index.html file and make a change over here. Action is not welcome. Action here is demo Servlet. It should go to demo Servlet page. Save this. Okay. Then we let us stop the server. Yeah, stop the server. Now server has stopped. Now again, we have made the changes. Now again go to test HTML and run it. Run as, run on server. The form is again displayed. Here I'll write now Ankit and click on login. Now it is showing welcome Ankit. So have you understood now what changes has to be done? We'll come back to our presentation. So here this we have seen. Now this is a simple question for you people. Which servlet request method is used in the program? Try to answer it. We have just now seen it. The answer is get parameter. Get parameter is an important method to retrieve data from HTML page. Okay. Now here same thing. If I come down to Eclipse, if I want to make this, I want to change this name Ankit to something else, I'll stop this. Or we'll come back and try to make some other name. Let's say Ram, login. So welcome Ram. So this is how it is working. Understood. So in index.html page, we have written action is demo servlet, method is get. So this method is important. When you're writing get, it is going to do get method. So this all data inside it will call to do get because I'm using a method type as get. Okay, and what we have done in demo servlet? In demo servlet, we are using this request.get parameter name. This, if I change something over here, if I make it n, name equal to n, in demo servlet get parameter, it should be n, not name. This both things should be same. This is very important to understand. Once you understand it, it is very easy. So this name and demo servlet should be same. Okay. Now these are some of the references which I have used. You can go back and study with it. You can practice more. You can make some changes. Let it have some error. No issues. But practice makes you perfect. Okay. Thank you.